My dear children, in this session we are going to deal with mobile communication technologies. That is the first generation and second generation mobile communication technologies and its developments. The mobile is an amazing technical achievement. It is having the key features like mind-blowing performances, jaw-dropping graphics, high-quality multimedia, long battery life, broadband speed, and reliable connectivity. The connectivity is a foundation of a great mobile experience. The connect reliably, connect on the go, talk and browse with a seamless mobility anywhere you get a signal. Connect longer, go longer without plugging in with improved battery efficiency. Like that, it connects fast. Stream, surf, upload, download with fast and predictable data rates. Connects real time. Get instant access to the content with less delay for always on experience. Mobile communication technologies is based on cellular networks or mobile networks. A cellular network is nothing but a radio network which divides a land into areas called cells. Every cell in the network has a transmitter and a receiver, also known as cell site or base station. Each cell in a network uses different frequency for the transmission of signals. The network of signals enables the mobile devices to communicate even if they are moving from one cell to another via base station. These single cell systems were severely constrained by restricted mobility and low capacity, limited service, and poor speech quality. Also, the equipment was heavy and bulky. Also, it is expensive and susceptible to interference. To overcome all these difficulties, the use of semiconductor technology and microprocessors made mobile systems become smaller, lighter, and more sophisticated. The mobile processors that you already know are Intel, Snapdragon, like that. Coming to the first generation mobile systems, which are introduced in 1970s and early 1980s. The 1G mobile system was based on analog cellular technology, that is frequency division multiplexing and time division multiple access. They only had voice facility available and were based on circuit switched technology. In 1G mobile system, voice was modulated to a frequency of about 150 MHz and higher. They used radio towers for transmissions. The major drawback of 1G system were its low capacity, poor voice links, and no security. Coming to the features, its speed was up to 2.4 kbps. It allows voice calls in one country. It uses analog signals. AMPS was first launched in US in 1G mobile system. Coming to the second generation, there is many disadvantages in 1G telecommunications, so that the second generation having more advantages than first generation wireless communications. The 2G mobile system was introduced in early 1990s. they used digital signals for transmission of voice, whereas in first generation they uses only analog signals. It provides paging, that is nothing but paging, emailing, SMS, voicemail and fax services. Both voice and data can be transmit. Data is nothing but a file or a written document or a typed document. It is based on GSM technology along with the SIM. SIM is nothing but subscriber identification module. They are having a unique identification number also. They used circuit switching. 2.5G mobile system used GPRS. They provide services like MMS, multimedia, SMS. Sending pictures through email become possible. Coming to the key features, the 2G is based on GSM and GPRS. It was launched in Finland in the year of 1991. It uses digital signals. Its speed is up to 64 kbps. It can send MMS, multimedia messages. It provides better quality and capacity than first generation devices. Thank you.